wouldn't be caught dead in a female store. He didn't even know what it all was about, or what it even was for. But on that particular day, he met new friends at school, and they took advantage of him. They blindfolded him, and as a dare, they left him in a store. Norton counted in his head very slowly to 30. He didn't know what he was getting himself into. The male stood out like a sore thumb in the store.
"29, 30,"
Norton said, a little bit louder than a whisper. He then undid his blindfold, and his mouth dropped open. The cashier was staring at him and a few other ladies. They giggled as they saw his cheeks flush.
"Hey, are you okay?" "Let's get you out of here."
Afterwards, Vivian and Norton went to a little cafe. They ordered drinks and talked a bit, becoming more than just strangers.
"Hi, my name's Libby, and I'll be your server today. Is there anything that I can start you guys off with?"
"I'll just take a mocha, please,
and no sugar." "Well, I don't really drink coffee. I'll just take a black tea, please."
"Alrighty."
Norton came from a really sheltered, poor family. So going to Vivian's house was a little overwhelming.
"This place is crazy. I mean, it's amazing."
"It is really no big deal. It's just my house. Or, well, my parents' American house."
"Thanks for, having me over."
"Of course. It was truly my pleasure. But you must come back tomorrow if your parents don't kill you.
Really? You'd have me over again?
I'd love to have you over again. I really did enjoy your company.
Yeah, same here.
Instantly, Norton knew that he had fallen in love with this girl that he barely knew. Since he had been homeschooled for practically his whole life, he didn't have very much social contact, and he didn't really know how to explain his feelings. But Vivian, on the other hand, had had many previous relationships. She wasn't taking advantage of Norton. She really liked him too. But unlike Norton, she didn't exactly realize how much she really did like him. Over a span of about 3 months, they did so much together. They would lay by each other's side, just listening to what another had to say, or simply listening to each other's soft breathing. Norton had never showed anyone his shed, or what he liked to call his own little private house. It was really just a small little building out in the woods where he could escape. He liked her so much that he'd even write short little poems about her, which was also another first for him. One day, things took a dark turn. Norton had picked a beautiful pink flower for Vivian, one he thought she'd love. He came to her house to find that she was talking to a stranger that he didn't know. At first glance, his heart stopped. He couldn't believe what he was seeing. He was so angry, but he didn't show an ounce of anger to Vivian or Jack.
Norton!
He just bottled it up inside, but it was written all over his puppy dog's face that he was deeply hurt.
This is my good old friend,
Jacques from France.
Oh yeah, right, of course. Nice to meet you.
We were planning to go get a cup of coffee or something. Would you like to come with us?
No. I'll be fine. I'll just be on my way.
Alright.
About 5 minutes later, he walked back to our house. But they weren't on the couch anymore.
Norton? Learn how to knock.
After Vivian said her sarcastic response, as she usually did, she realized that she really did hurt him. He left. He ran so fast. He just kept running and running and running. And soon it was night. And he couldn't see where he was going from all the tears that were streaming down his face. He was blinded by them. And at the same time, two teenagers were out drinking and driving. They could barely see either. And in the blink of an eye, Norton was hit.
Simple words wholeheartedly said, nothing eloquent but beautifully read. It was the way I felt.
Really did actually love him. But she realized it too late. She ran after him. She ran to his shed. He wasn't there. She ran to his parents' house. He wasn't there. She ran to every place that he could possibly be. But Norton wasn't to be found. Vivian couldn't take it. The weight was too much. She was sweating. She was going crazy inside. Screaming inside. Praying that he was okay. When the nurse finally came out and called her name, she was so happy. She ran to him. she realized.